Shifting our focus now to the hearing, which will take place anytime now in the Supreme Court on the UP government's directive asking restaurant owners to display the name and identity of the owners. Before hearing in the Supreme Court, the Uttar Pradesh government, in fact, has filed an affidavit. This is the UP government's response, challenging the interim stay on its order requiring eateries to display their names during the Kanwad Yatra. The state government has claimed that this order is essential for maintaining peace and transparency. In their affidavit, the UP government has mentioned that the order was implemented in response to complaints that they received from the Kanwadiyas. The affidavit further claims that the rule applies to all communities and is intended to prevent any disruptions. The state government also clarified that there is no ban on trade except for the sale of non-vegetarian food items. We're getting some breaking inputs now. The Congress party has hit out at the Bharatiya Janata Party, calling Kanwad Yatra order on eateries divisive. Congress party says they want the top court to put a permanent stay on Yogi government's order. Let's first listen into the reactions that we're getting.
ये बात सुप्रीम कोर्ट के सामने उत्तर प्रदेश सरकार की दलील जाएगी, लेकिन मैं मानता हूं ये समाज के लिए विभाजनकारी आदेश था, ये संविधान की मंशा के खिलाफ था और इसीलिए सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने उस पर अंतरिम रोक लगाई है। प्रकरण चूंकि सर्वोच्च न्यायालय के विचाराधीन है, मुझे आशा है जो अंतरिम स्थगन आदेश है वही निर्णय बनेगा।
बीजेपी हैज फाइल्ड अ रिप्लाई वेयर इट्स ट्राइंग टू जस्टिफाई व्हाट इट हैड डन। इट्स लेट द कोर्ट डिसाइड बिकॉज देयर इज नो पॉइंट ऑफ माय सेइंग एनीथिंग अबाउट इट। बट आई नो फॉर श्योर दैट यू नो यू कैन ब्रिंग रिस्ट्रिक्शंस और यू कैन टॉक ऑफ ट्रांसपेरेंसी in the name of food safety, in the name of hygiene, in the name of public order. But this is only giving names to fruit vendors and small people. Now, I don't think this has any factor of hygiene or safety. It's only a divisive politics.
So Congress party calls it divisive politics. UP government says that we received some complaints from the Kanwadiyas, keeping religious sentiments in mind and also to ensure transparency, we issued this directive. And Tejshree is joining us with more details. Tejshree, the UP government is also citing some discrepancies when it comes to the identity of the owners and the names that are displayed on the boards.
Yes, UP government has told the Supreme Court that in fact this decision was taken because the Kanwad Yatris themselves complained about such kind of incidents happening, and in fact it was done to ensure that the religious sentiments of Kanwad Yatris do not get affected, and that is why this particular decision was taken. Number one. Number two, they have also said that several complaints were received by Kanwad Yatris that such kind of things have been done which are hurting the religious sentiment. Number two. Number three, they have also said that this decision or this order or this particular notification was rolled out keeping in mind that earlier also such kind of incidents have taken place in the state of Uttar Pradesh, and to maintain a peace and law and order and to have a transparency, this order was rolled out. And that number four, it has nothing to do with hurting or creating religious discrimination in this area or the state of Uttar Pradesh. In fact, the priority was to maintain peace and law and order. Let me tell you that I am reporting from this Muzaffarnagar, from where this particular dhaba where they have still put up the name of the owners of the shop along with the picture. However, when we ask them that despite the Supreme Court order that it is not compulsory to now put or mention the name along with the nameplate, but still they say that for a safer site, for the safety purpose, they have kept the name displayed. They have displayed the name along with the owner. However, now they have reduced the number of boards. Earlier there were 4 to 5 boards, but now they have reduced it to number one. Now they say that they are waiting for the final hearing in the Supreme Court, and whatever the court says, they will be going with that particular decision.
Back to you. Tejshree, stay on with us. We also have our legal editor Harish joining us on the broadcast. Harish, Supreme Court had halted this directive and sought responses from the governments of UP, Uttarakhand. Now, UP government has responded in the affidavit. It is justifying its decision, saying, we have kept in mind religious sentiments. We want to ensure peace and transparency. And moreover, we've received complaints from the Kanwadiyas.
Yes, in fact, Swati, why today's hearing will be very important is because from the last date of hearing, the Supreme Court had found prima facie merit in the argument of Mahua Moitra and Association for Civil Rights of leading NGO of UP and also several civil rights activists that this is nothing but economic boycott of Muslims, exclusion by identity, very, very serious allegations raised against the UP government, and there's no rationale for explanation. And today, and last time this order was passed, it was an ex parte order without hearing the UP government and Uttarakhand government. Today, the UP government has filed its affidavit, and according to my sources, Senior Advocate Mukul Rohatgi will be appearing for the UP government and be putting a very strong defense. And as Tejri said, the UP government has strongly defended the directive issued by the state and says it is responding to the complaints received from the Kavadiyas regarding confusion caused by the names of shops and eateries, and also in the interest of dietary preferences of Kavadiyas. And also the
so they justified their decision. The UP government says this is not discrimination based on religion or caste. This is to avoid potential confusion. And it applies to everybody, all the restaurant owners, irrespective of their caste or religion. Stay on with us, Harish and Tejri. We have some political reactions coming in. You earlier heard the Congress hit out at the BJP. Now, the BJP is defending itself and giving a counter. BJP claims that this order is just for maintaining harmony and has nothing to do with communities.
ये हमेशा हम लोग ध्यान रखते हैं कि कोई ऐसी चीज ना हो जाए, कोई ऐसा संगठन उसमें ऐसा ना कर दे जिससे कांवड़ियों पर कुछ हो, और अगर कुछ हो जाएगा तो सांप्रदायिक दंगे से कोई रोक नहीं सकता। तो इसलिए जो व्यवस्था की गई है कानून व्यवस्था के लिए था ये, इसमें कोई धर्म और जाति की बात नहीं थी। मैं योगी सरकार, उत्तर प्रदेश सरकार के जो एफिडेविट है, उन्होंने शपथ पत्र दिया है, उसकी मैं सराहना करता हूँ।
Tejri continues to be with us. We also have Siddharth joining us in the broadcast. So the UP government in the affidavit says we want to give the Kanwadiyas a choice, an informed choice on where they want to eat from, especially after they received some complaints about irregularities in the display of the names and the actual identities. Take us through the affidavit.
So this is a very important affidavit that's been filed by the UP government today, Swati. And let me just take you through some important portions where the UP government is basically making a point that we're taking these precautions on the grounds of law and order and preventing any flare-up. In fact, it's also cited examples of Muslim festivals as well where certain additional precautions are taken. So in para 7 of this affidavit, the UP government says the state is obliged not to discriminate on the grounds of religion. Hence, during festivals of all communities, both majority and minority, special attention is bestowed by the state. For instance, traffic restrictions are in place all over the state during the holy festivals of Muharram and Eid. In fact, as is well known, arrangements are made for village fairs for the sale and purchase of goats during that period. Even the movement of pigs is restricted as it would offend the religious sensibilities of the minority community, which by and large consider pigs unclean and do not partake of pig meat. It is a matter of common knowledge that during the Hajj season, when pilgrims go to Mecca, Medina, after registration with the Hajj Committee of the Government of India, special care is taken by the center and states, including at airports, to ensure availability of special wazoo facilities, prayer areas, dedicated check-in counters, and Hajj guest houses for the rest prior to reaching the airport. Now, let me take you through the conclusions as well of the UP government when it justifies its decision. It says that it's also submitted that the state has imposed no ban or prohibition on the trade or business of the food sellers except the restriction of selling non-vegetarian food, and they are free to conduct their business as usual. The requirement to display the names and identities of owners is merely an additional measure to ensure transparency and avoid any potential confusion among the Kavadiyas. That it also is to be noted that directives do not impose any discrimination based on religion, caste or community. The requirement to display the names and identities of the owners applies uniformly to all food sellers along the Kavad Yatra route, irrespective of their religious or community affiliations. That the directives are also aimed at ensuring public safety and order during the Kavad Yatra, given the large number of participants and the potential for communal tension, it is imperative to take preventive measures that ensure a peaceful and harmonious pilgrimage. Past incidents have shown that misunderstandings regarding the type of food being sold have led to tensions and disturbances. The directives are a proactive measure to avoid such situations. And if you actually go down towards the end of the affidavit, there's a detailed annexure as well, which points out as to what the certain Kavad Yatra routes are across Muzaffarnagar as well as Saharanpur. And very importantly, they've also appended certain photographs, Swati, of shops which bear, for example, this is the Raja Ram Bhoj family tourist dhaba. The dhaba name is Raja Ram Bhoj, Nahi Mandi, Muzaffarnagar. The proprietor happens to be a certain Mr. Vaseem, resident of Saket Colony, Civil Line in Muzaffarnagar. Next, dhaba name Rajasthani Shoot Khalsa Dhaba, Nahi Mandi, Muzaffarnagar. The proprietor is a certain Furkan, son of Habib, resident of Kukra, New Mandi in Muzaffarnagar. Finally, Pandit Ji Vaishno Dhaba, that's the name of the dhaba, and the proprietor happens to be a certain Sanavar Rathod, resident of Nagla Ruth, P.S. Khatoli in Muzaffarnagar. So these are some photographs that the UP government has attached to its affidavit, citing possible confusion that might arise in the event that the name of the proprietor is not displayed very prominently along the covered yatra route. So it's a detailed submission. It remains to be seen now as to how the court responds to this.
All right, Siddha, thank you very much for putting things into context. Let me go back to Tejri, who's getting us some ground reports. Tejri, like you said earlier, the shop owners, the dhaba owners have said that they'll go by what the government decides, that they'll go by whatever the Supreme Court has to say. Now, in the affidavit, the government, of course, is justifying its decision, citing peace, citing transparency, and saying that they want to give Kanwadiyas the right to make an informed choice.
Yes, government is justifying, UP government is justifying themselves in the affidavit that has been filed in the Supreme Court. And in fact, the UP government also says that to avoid any kind of confusion, this particular order was taken. This particular order was rolled out. Now, let me show you the shops over here and the name and why UP government probably is saying this. It is just because, as I showed earlier also, as we showed earlier also, that this is the Tiranga tea stall, but it belongs to Afan Bhai. Then let us roll our pan, our camera, and show that next cafe, that is UP 12 King Cafe. It belongs to Mohammed Khalid, Mohammed Shadab and Salman. Next cafe, that its name is Happy Moments Royal Cafe. It belongs to a person named Salman. So probably when there is no display of the name, it creates a confusion in the minds of Kanwadiyatri, so as to where they have to go, what kind of food they will be getting over here. So that is why, to avoid such kind of confusion, this decision has been taken by the Uttar Pradesh government, is what the government justifies. Now, if we'll also try to speak to the shopkeeper owner himself, who is in fact still displaying the name and waiting for the final order of the Supreme Court. Ye bataiye ki aapne abhi tak naam rakha hua hai, iska karan kya hai, kab tak aap wait kar rahe order?
Bas aaj order aayega, dekhen fir kya order milta hai, kya order aata hai, uske baad dekhenge.
Lekin court ne kaha tha ki ab zaruri nahi hai naam lagana, fir bhi aapne kyu display kiya?
Bas display to rakha hai, yahan kavad bhi nahi aati, shaant pade, kaam bhi down hai. बिल्कुल रास्ते बंद कर दिए, जाम कर दिए, बस लग रहा है, सोच रहे कावड़ बाद ही हटा देंगे बस.
तो आपको लग रहा है कि कावड़ यात्री इस डिस्प्ले के कारण कुछ फर्क पड़ रहा है कि किसी और दुकानों में जा
ही नहीं है यहाँ? जब रास्ते बंद कर दिए तो काम तो है ही नहीं बिल्कुल भी, सब बंद पड़े हैं.
अच्छा, आता नहीं है फिलहाल? अभी
नहीं आ रहा है, कावड़ भी नहीं आ रहे, वैसा आदमी भी नहीं आ रहा जब रास्ता ही ब्लॉक.
आपको लगता है कि इस तरह का नोटिफिकेशन आपके काम पे असर करता है या फिर होना चाहिए, नहीं होना चाहिए, आपको क्या लगता है?
देखो, जब कावड़ यहाँ से डाक कावड़ चलेगी, आएगी या नहीं आएगी तब मालूम.
दुकानदार, आपको लगता है होना चाहिए?
हाँ, होना चाहिए.
ठीक है. But now they are waiting for the final decision of the Supreme Court. However, most of the shopkeeper owners have kept the name along with the pictures on their displayed on their shop. But they are just waiting for the final verdict from the Supreme Court, the final word from the Supreme Court. And then they will be taking decisions so as to what will happen to these nameplates. Will they be kept as it is or will they be removing it? Back to you.
Government, like I said, has been justifying its decision in that affidavit also. In its response to the Supreme Court, UP government says that this directive is in no way discrimination based on religion or caste, but in fact, it brings uniformity. And politically speaking, Tejri, the BJP has been hitting hard at the Congress and the Samajwadi Party, reminding them of how, you know, this was brought during the UPA era and was implemented during Mulayam Singh Yadav's regime.
Absolutely, the political war of words have erupted since when the order was rolled out. And in fact, let me tell you that Muzaffarnagar police had held a press conference in which they announced that this decision has been taken. And that now
we have Mr. Rashid Alvi of the Congress joining us on the broadcast. Bahut bahut shukriya hamare sath judne ke liye. Mr. Alvi, the UP government in its affidavit says that this directive is after they received complaint from the Kanwadiyas. This is to ensure peace. And, you know, this is to ensure that the Kanwadiyas can make an informed choice. Nowhere does it discriminate on the basis of religion or caste. That's their stand.
It is absolutely wrong. It is, they are just is spreading hatred in the state, and if our Chief Minister Yogi Adityanath, they have so much love for Kavadiyas, then I think he could lead himself all the procession of Kavadiyas. Police is going to the owners of shopkeepers belonging Hindu community and putting pressure. Musalmanon ko nikal do bahar. You know it very well. It has come in the media also. So what is happening? It is Yogi Adityanath. He knows he is unable to learn any lesson from the parliamentary election. He has lost parliamentary election in Uttar Pradesh. But he is unable to learn any lesson from it.
Now, some, you know, already have implemented the directive, some that we are speaking to. Nobody so far has been speaking about the discrimination angle that you're highlighting. But what is your response to the BJP saying that this was brought in during the UP era, implemented by Mulayam Singh Yadav? You had no problems then. Now you're raising this issue. How do you respond to that?
This is the basic politics of BJP. They never talk about any development program. They never talk about price rise. They always talk Hindu Muslim. And not only Yogi, even our Pradhan Mantri. During parliamentary election, main Muslimanon ka reservation jab tak zinda hu nahi hone dunga. Who is asking you reservation? Any Muslim has requested you to give us reservation? Nobody. You yourself speak all this nonsense. So this is the basic politics of Bharatiya Janata Party, to create a great wall between Hindus and Muslims. Nothing else. So you know this Kavadiya program, it is going on for a very, very long time. For 1,000 years, it has never happened. Why it is happening only this year? Even Yogi Adityanath is ruling over Uttar Pradesh for last 7-8 years.
Affidavit, sir, they are saying you received some complaints from the Kavadiyas and they want the Kavadiyas to make an informed choice, and that's the reason why this directive.
Kavadiyas are playing with the law and order situation, not shopkeepers. How can it be? Shopkeepers do this. They are earning bread. They are earning money for the family. They can't do it. I challenge Yogi Adityanath. He show me complaints. He show these complaints to you also. Just he's talking nonsense. We have received complaints.
Okay.
When did you receive complaints?
They should put out proof of the complaints that they've received. But the Yogi government says this is not a ban on trade. This is just a directive to display the names and identities of the owners. Thank you very much, Mr. Alvi. Thank you to Tejshree as well for getting us those reactions and live inputs. We're moving on now. Several areas.